Wendy, how, good morning. How are you?
Morning, Charlotte. I'm fine. How are you?
I'm okay, thank you. And I'm sorry we didn't make an episode last week, but that is because of the coronavirus and the kids are home, isn't that
Yes.
true? Sorry, that was my cat.
Sweet cat.
I like your hat. That's your witch's hat.
With my witch's hat. Yeah.
Wow. Did you make that bend in it, or did you fall off your broomstick?
Ja, het is helemaal in vorm. Hè? Dat, ja.
So you made it like that. You didn't fall off your broomstick.
No.
Good. I'm glad you didn't have an accident. And is
Nee.
that paper or is that material?
Dus van materials, van, ja, noem je stof in het Engels?
Material.
Material, ja. Yeah.
Ja.
Ja, kijk, en mijn het is
Okay.
material.
Nice one. Well, we are going to do the witch's oracle. The next card is the cauldron, which is also depicted on the front of the book, the witch's oracle deck by Marla Brooks. And we've had a very good reactions, many reactions, and likes to the video and the episode, the series. So a lot of people are interested, and we've had a quick we've somebody said, I didn't know that the broom was so important. And they said, yes, in some other cultures, it's sweeping away the old and letting the new in at New Year. So it was nice to hear somebody giving a reaction. Have you received any reactions?
Een paar reacties, ja.
You
Ja,
did
van
like several reactions. Okay. And were they
Nee.
nice? Were they questions or were they answers?
Ik zeg het even in Nederland. Nee, ze zeiden van, oh, wat leuke vlog en wat leuk en daar moet je mee doorgaan. En ja, ze mogen het allemaal graag zien. Het maakt wat meer duidelijk. En ook, ze
Saying
zeiden
she's
dat.
Whitney is saying yes, which is a nice, it's a nice vlog, it's a nice series. You have to continue doing this because we can learn from it and we enjoy seeing you and getting the information.
Ja, maar ook zo van hè, dat ik in het Nederlands dan het goed onderbouw van de kaarten nog meer dan dat de kaarten zijn, zeg maar. Dat heb ik gehoord. Dus dat is wel leuk.
Okay, Wendy says it is great stuff to it's not it, you've supported it. You've got the facts and you've got the information. You've done it very nicely by supporting the cards. You're making the cards even more important or coming alive to us. Okay, so we're going to do the witch's cauldron. Do you use one of these cauldrons, Wendy?
Ja, ik gebruik deze sowieso voor het maken voor bepaalde brouwseltjes, maar ook om daar de rituelen in te doen voor nou, de offerschaal, als het ware, maak ik er dan van. Ja, dus ook het klaarmaken voor
Wendy,
lekkere.
Wendy uses this to make how do you call it sauces and so she puts all the stuff like herbs and everything in it to for offerings and she uses it like a real witch should.
Ja, dat klopt. En ook ja, je gebruikt het voor verschillende recepten klaar te maken. Gewoon lekker om in te koken. Hè, voor buiten zo'n ketel. En ja, goed, in het verleden heb ik dat wel met mensen gedaan. Maar ik wil zelf ook een grote ketel nog ooit een keer kopen. Dat ik we buiten lekker een soepje erin kunnen maken of wat anders. En dan met het gezin. Ja, dat lijkt me fantastisch.
She also uses it outside with friends, but one day she would love to have a bigger cauldron. It's like a picnic or a barbecue, but it's a witch's barbecue, I suppose. I'll have to come to one of these meetings.
Yeah,
Anyway,
yeah, yeah.
this is the card I'm going to read. So whilst I'm reading, I hope you can see the card. I will do this in English. I will do this in English. The screen might fall away because it's, I don't know how to stop the timer. So this is Gerwin's cauldron. The cauldrons in general are symbols of transmutation, germination, and transformation. The belief that the cauldron symbolizes the womb of the great goddess arises from the concept that everything is born out of it and returns to it. Cauldrons have held a magical significance in many cultures throughout the centuries and still do. Gerwin, I don't know how to say that name, was an enchantress. Her cauldron is a familiar concept in many pagan faiths and is considered to be a traditional source of inspiration, or even modern pagans do make reference to Sir Dwyn's cauldron as a holder of all the secrets of the universe and the place where wisdom is brewed. The meaning of the card is you've been standing over your cauldron for quite a while, stirring up new ideas. It's now time to take the cauldron off the fire and put those ideas into good use. Remember, stirring for too long over a high heat will evaporate the contents and all will be lost. So in other words, this card is for new ideas. Don't take too long to think about them, but come into action and make them come true. The crystal that you can use is Gouda, a Gouda hollow rocks lined with crystals. It's like the amethyst with the center. I'll show you one in a minute. They help to include new ideas. Hollow rocks lined with crystals resembles cauldrons when split open. They help you incubate new ideas and invite you to witness the mysteries of transformation, transmutation. Meditate on a Gouda for inspired wisdom. Now I'm going to get you mine. It just so happens I have one. The Gouda that I have looks like this. And it's cut in half. And that is what a Gouda is. So yeah, with this stone, you can meditate. And I suppose when you are meditating, you hold it open to, you can see the crystals in it. I don't know whether it's amethyst, but I think so. It could be another stone forming here. And then once you've meditated, you close the stone with your ideas until you're ready to put them into action.
Very nice.
Thank you. So the incantation that you can use for the cauldron is, or the affirmation, a pinch of this, a pinch of that, all mixed and blended in a fat. No need to get caught in the undertow. Ideas are in place and ready to go. I love it, I love it. Like a stroke. It's just like a spell.
And a richer spell, yeah.
Okay. So go ahead and give us your definition of the cauldron, please, Wendy.
Deze kaart staat voor een bepaalde transformatie. Het doorgeven van een nieuw stukje toekomst. Want dat wordt hier ook mee gezegd. Het is een kaart. Sowieso nieuwe ideeën, nieuwe ontploppingen als het ware. Een stukje wijsheid opdoen van nieuwe ideeën. Maar dat kan sowieso voor je geestelijke zijn, voor de transformatie. Maar ook nieuwe ideeën voor mooie, fijne recepten samen met je maken voor je, met je gezin.
The cauldron means new ideas, But also to let ideas come out, and also to cook together with a friend or with a fellow witch or wizard.
Ja, maar het is gewoon een stukje transformatie. Hè? Die kaart, als je die trekt in het deck, is het voor nieuwe ideeën, samen, samenhorigheid, samen, maar doen.
So it means being together. Okay, it's like a lot of witches stir the pot.
Ja, ja. En dan vaak in drievoud, hè, wordt er gezegd van alles.
Often in threefold, because that is what the witches believe. Like I always say, when you karma, you'll get it back threefold, whether it's good or bad. With the witches, it is always threefold, and so be it. So above, so below.
Yeah, yeah, close.
Okay. Thank you. So shall we go on to the next card, the chalice? That is the chalice. Okay, and I've got the card here. Now, I'll read the chalice, and the chalice is the fourth of the major tools of magic is the chalice. This vessel may be used for everyday drinking, but is usually reserved for occasions when it is felt necessary to pour libations to the gods, giving thanks to the gods or offerings, or similar ritual use. A chalice can serve multiple purposes. It can be used as a focal point for meditation, and when you hold a chalice in both hands at eye level, it creates an atmosphere of magic. The chalice, the meaning of the chalice, chalices are filled with liquid. Liquids hold no shape and is in a constant state of change. Emotions are like water and are constantly changing from moment to moment. Emotionally, you've been sloshing around and coming very close to spilling over. It's time to steady yourself so that you can carry on and do all those things that need to be done. In other words, take control of your emotions and your ideas. The crystal gemstone is aquamarine. Aquamarine is the quintessential stone of water element. It helps to bring clarity and movement to the mind and emotions. Work with aquamarine when you seek greater mental emotional balance. The incantation or affirmation you can say with the chalice is both feet planted on the ground. There's no need to flop around. Calm and balanced will be the way to welcome each brand new day.
Beautiful. I have one.
You've got a chalice. Yes, you. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And do you use it when you do spells?
Yeah.
Or healings?
Yes. Ja, met rituelen doe ik het dan. Ja.
Wendy uses her chalice when she does her rituals or healing or spells.
Alleen vaak wordt het gebruikt in de hekserij om daar wijn in te doen. Of een ander drankje wat alcohol in zit. Maar ik drink geen alcohol, dus ik gebruik geen alcoholische dranken in mijn rituelen.
Usually it is filled with wine or another liquid that also has alcohol in it. But Wendy doesn't drink alcohol, so she doesn't use it with wine or alcohol substances. Okay, yeah. Wendy. Yeah. Great. Nice. What is your definition of the chalice, Wendy?
De kaart duidt in principe aan, het is een constante verandering als het ware in je leven. Dus ook zo met vloeistof. Vloeistof verandert ook naarmate het de dag door, maar ook het kan veranderen. Veranderen van emoties en veranderen van een op andere moment. Daar staat deze kaart voor. Dan ga ik zo verder vertellen, omdat je eerst even vertaalt.
She says that the chalice means holding a substance and everything is changing. Like the book says, that fluid can change and that it can slosh over. And it's just also means balance.
Ja, en ook eigenlijk geeft de kaart ook aan, doen wat je doen moet. Zorg draagkracht voor jezelf en blijf jezelf en verander niet door een ander. Dat is een heel belangrijk punt. Dus zorg draagkracht, zorgkracht voor jezelf.
It also means stay within your power, be yourself, do what you must do. And I usually say, when I worked in the healthcare, I used to say to my clients, this is what I'm going to do. So in other words, say what you do and do what you say.
Ja, niet laten veranderen door andere meningen van andere mensen.
En dat don't is ook, let people change your mind. Don't let anybody change your mind. You decide and stay in your strength. Okay, don't let anybody change your mind or change you.
Ja. En dat is dus de kaart, zeg maar, de beschrijving daarbij. Ja, heel belangrijk.
That is what the card means according to Wendy. Thank you, Wendy. Shall we go on to the dragon?
Yes.
We've got a Chinese dragon here. What does the dragon mean? Usually, sometimes in England, we say, you're a dragon. And that's when somebody's bossy or dominating. And they're being nasty. You're a dragon, like somebody pushing their will onto somebody else. Okay, so I'm going to read it. Chinese dragon. Dragon is a legendary creature, typically depicted as a large and powerful serpent with magical or spiritual qualities. They are highly intelligent, unlike European dragons. Chinese dragons are considered to be benevolent and symbolize potent and auspicious powers. They symbolize, symbolically stand for power, wisdom, strength, and good luck. They have the power to bless and influence our lives. Chinese dragons are referred to as divine creatures that bring them abundance and prosperity, and are the ultimate symbol of good fortune. But we are never handed these gifts on a silver platter. Like the diligent dragon that never gives up, you must work hard to overcome the many obstacles standing before you in order to achieve the success you desire. This dragon offers you all the tools you need to make that happen. Trust in him, hold him back close, and draw the luck and goddess out of him. I'm sorry, I've got to do something. I think. Okay, no, it's good. It's good. I thought there was something technical, so you can see it. Sorry, guys. The stone that you can use is the earliest depictions of dragons found in the world are carvings in jade. The date of to ancient China, jade is a stone of good fortune, balance, harmony, and virtue. Empower a piece of jade to help you surmount any challenge that you face and inspire greater peace in your life. The incantation that you can say is, jump the hurdles, rise above, give all the problems a mighty shelf. I can do this. Yes, I can. Confidence is my master plan. That's it. So you can wear jade and that will bring you wisdom, fortune, etc., etc.
Ja. Ja. De kaart, hè, die staat ook voor een stuk vertrouwen. Je kan vertrouwen op de draak. Het is een symbool waar je op aan kan. En de draak, hè, die geeft je geluk. Je kan vragen, je kan alle dingen vragen waar je mee zit, kan je vragen aan de draak. Want de draak geeft je antwoord.
The symbol of this card is the dragon. The dragon means that you can ask the dragon anything that you wish. And what else, Wendy?
Dat je volledig kan vertrouwen op de draak. Je kan de draak aanspreken.
You can completely trust the dragon.
Ja, en het is ook zo, de draak biedt je mogelijkheden om geluk na te streven. En dat gaat je ook lukken.
The dragon will offer you fortune and power. Anything that you wish, and that is what he will push you to do.
Ja, laat je in je kracht staan. Dat is zo.
Makes you stand in your power.
Ja, ja, klopt. Dat klopt. Ja, het is een mooie symbool, een draak. Een draak is voor mij ook heel erg belangrijk. Ja. Ja, ik zal mijn exot even afdoen. Ik zal jullie aantonen, want wat ik heb, ik weet niet of het goed zichtbaar is. Het goed zichtbaar nu?
Je kan de tatoeage zien en de vleugels. Ja. You can see the dragon. You can see the dragon in Wendy's ear, and you can see it's like a bat, but also it's too. You can't do it very well on the camera, but that is Wendy's tattoo or tattoo of a dragon.
Ja, kun je het goed zien? Ja.
Ja, ja. Was that painful, Wendy?
Nee, nee. No.
It wasn't painful. Okay.
No. Hey, it was not painful.
You've got another tattoo there. Ah, that's the moon.
Lovely.
And a dream catcher. A dream catcher, yes. But that's the sign of the high priestess on the tarot.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I like the dream catcher with the two moons. Nice one.
The triple moon and the pentagram inside with the, yeah.
The dream. What is the triple moon with the pentagram of the witches, and it is shaped in also into a dream catcher, which is, I think, a very nice tattoo, but that's personally.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I have many tattoos from the witchery. I have the raven from Odin.
Yeah, and you've got the card of the raven, so we'll come back to that tattoo when we do the raven.
Yeah.
You've got the crow as well in the deck, so that's awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that was lovely. Now we've got the crystal ball.
Yeah.
And I think that's, we've got four then, but because we missed an episode last week, we'll do an extra card this week, and next week we'll do an extra card if we can, and then we'll catch up in that way. So we've got the crystal ball. I've got a crystal ball. Do you have a crystal ball?
Yeah, a little one. I have a little ball.
I have as well. It's smoky crystal.
Oh, nice.
That's from the Himalayas. My sister brought it back for me.
Wow, very nice. I have one, I have a bergkristal.
Heldere kristal?
Nee, no, it was a white color.
Yeah, it's helemaal gewoon heldere kristal dat jij hebt. Je hebt geen floors erin.
Ja, er zit wel wit van binnen. Het is een witte bergkristal.
She's got white crystal. White. You've got white bits. I've got also copper or iron or gold in this.
Ja, ja. Nee, het is voor mij echt een witte, maar ook wit, hè, van binnenin. Echt wit van kleur. Ik kan hem pakken, want ik heb hem in mijn tas.
She's going to fetch her crystal ball.
Yeah.
But this is the one, and you, every time you see something different.
Yeah. I have them. Like, this is my crystal ball.
Ah, yes, that's quartz. That looks more like quartz. That's lovely.
Yeah.
I think that's the same size as mine. It's yeah. nice to take with you instead of such a big one.
Yeah, this one. Deze gaat me mee overal waar ik ga naar cliënten om te helpen.
Wendy takes her crystal ball to all her clients when she does a reading or healings, because Wendy is also a therapist and a masseur. So tell us a little bit about the kind of therapies that you do, Wendy.
Okay. De therapieën die ik doe verschillende. Dus mensen helpen. Dus ik ga dus een stukje terug in het verleden, het heden en een stukje toekomst.
Sure, Wendy goes back into the past and then into the present and then into the future.
Ja, dus dat is wat ik doe, contact met overleden personen.
She's a medium, a psychic. She can make contact, like I do, with the people that have departed to the other realm. And some people call this heaven.
Ja, dat doe ik. Ik doe alle verschillende waarnemingen. Dus ik ben helderziend, helderwetend, helderruikend, helderdenkend, heldervoelend. Dus ja, alles met elkaar.
Wendy is the same as me. She's clairvoyant, audiovoyant, verbalvoyant. So she can hear people, she can see people, she can talk to the people. She can smell them, like sometimes I smell perfume or what they used to eat or what the soap that they washed with, or smoke of cigars, things like that. Yeah. Or some people used to wear flowers or puri, something like that, their clothes. I can smell scents. Like I've had it with clients. That you've got that soap with the Spanish dancer on it with the black dress. Well, I think it's called Maria or something like that. And the name just popped up whilst I was smelling it. And the perfume 4711, the eau de toilette, that came up as well once in a reading. And that's what Wendy means by smelling.
Yeah.
And she can also touch things, like something. If somebody, a client comes and says, can you tell me something about a ring or an object, she can feel that as well.
Of okay. A picture of a picture of a stone of an hollow and
a watch.
Yeah. Watch of
all any items she can that a person has worn or belonged to a person. Wendy picks up the energy and vibes from that deceased person or living person.
En wat ik ook doe is massages geven, Indiaanse hoofdmassages.
What kind of massages do you give?
Indiaanse hoofdmassage.
Head massage, yes.
Voetreflectie.
Reflexology on the feet.
And on the hands. And het magnetiseren, dus op
magnetize. It's a bit like Reiki, but it's without papers.
Ja, ik doe dan sowieso een drukmassage, oftewel drukpuntmassage.
Ja, dat is reflexology, toch?
Ja, maar dan wel over het hele lichaam. Dat is met spieren en de zenuwen.
He also does massage with typical points that you pressure, a pressure massage.
En daarbij doe ik dan ook magnetische, niet gewoon alleen magnetiseren, maar ik heb ook een magneet, ga ik over het lichaam heen van de mensen.
Magnets, and she goes over the, she's not only massaging, but also magnets that she uses over the whole of the body. And she does sell magnets as well. She does wear them herself as well, magnets. Can we have a look at your magnets?
Ja.
Je hebt er nog één aan op je vingers.
Ja, dat klopt. Maar ik kan het laten zien.
Okay.
Ik pak er gewoon erbij. I have my bag. I have the magneet.
Lots
this one. Yeah, for over the body. And I go to the clock round. And I count this one. And there's the min and the plus sides. And okay. I go.
The big side is the plus. And the top of the is the minus. So those are the polars, the plus and the minus. And she goes around the body like she just showed you, and that draws out the negative energy.
Yes, yeah, yeah. Just this one I have, yeah.
And which of your rings are magnets, Wendy?
This one. This ring.
That looks like an eye. It's lovely. It looks like a ruby.
Yeah, this one is met a magnetic. Yeah. Yeah.
And what for steen zit erin?
Ik weet het niet.
Fijn.
Weet ik niet. Ik heb geen idee. Maar ik heb hem gekregen van mijn ouders. Van
Fiona. She doesn't know what stone it is because her parents gave the ring to her.
Yeah.
It looks like a ruby or it looks like, what do you call it? Agate. Let's have a look.
Ik vind heel erg, maar ik verkoop ze zelf. Maar ik weet niet welke dat is nu. Want je hebt natuurlijk meerdere soorten. Dus dat, ik ben puur voor de kleur gegaan.
She went for the color. She didn't go for the stone. She went for the color. You've got different stones. Okay. Let's have a look. Well, last week I made a short film showing different types of stones like tiger's eye, and I got my gem book out, and garnet, that's it, garnet. It looks like garnet, look.
Yeah.
You've got brown garnet and you've got red garnet. And red garnets have a warm, fiery energy that fuels our passion and desires. The crystal structure helps to anchor our needs and wants into the physical plane. They are perfect tools for all kinds of manifestations. Work with garnet to ground and focus your magical work. Well, that's quite nice. So that is how we drifted away from the crystal ball, went on to magnets, went on to massage, and this is what makes this series interesting.
Yeah.
It's like being at a tea party, but I've got something to drink, but it isn't tea, it's water.
Nee, ja, ik doe ook nog veel meer andere dingen, maar goed, daar kunnen we het andere keer over hebben.
Okay, Wendy says I do a lot more things. And we'll talk about it next time or another time, bit by bit, Wendy.
Yeah.
So I'll start reading the crystal ball. Crystal ball. The crystal ball has been used by seers, fortune tellers, psychics and sorcerers as far back as medieval times. In Europe, it is one of the most well-known and popular methods of divination. To foresee of and foretell. Crystal balls were even used by royal counselors like Dr. John Dee, the trusted advisor of Queen Elizabeth I. He was known for his use of the crystal ball in his works. He was a scientist, an astronomer, the person that astrologer, that's another word for it. But it is not astrology, it is astronomy. I can't say the word. It's when you guide the maps, or when you guide yourself when you're on the boat. Astronomer is astronomy. I only know the Dutch word.
Yeah.
But in the olden days, people used to guide their way by the stars and the moon. So it's the opposite to astrology. Mathematician and geographer, but was also involved in hermetic philosophy and alchemy studies. He believed crystal would act as a communication device between him and the angels. The crystal ball in a reading indicates the necessity to find out information that cannot be seen by the naked eye, a necessity to find answers to questions that have been plaguing you, not only in regard to the future, but also the past, because our yesterdays define our tomorrows. Get in touch with who you were rather than who you are now, and you will find the answers you seek. The crystal gemstone quartz crystal provides clarity and insight. It can help you tap into the unseen world to glean value psychic insight. Gaze into a piece of quartz, preferably a sphere or tumbled stone, to help uncover the missing piece of the puzzle. The incantation that you can use: guide me back into my past, when visions weren't so overcast. I need to see all that I was in order to clear up the fuzz. En wat is your definition, Wendy?
Deze kaart is in principe de onzichtbare bewustwording.
Basically, the unseen conscious. So it means the subconscious. Sorry, Wendy.
Nee, geeft niet. Nee, wat vaak nog niet zichtbaar is, maar wel wat gaat komen, wat ze gezegd.
In other words, also your subconscious. It's not that also it shows or means that this card is that the unseen is there, but you don't know it yet, but could appear.
Het is een stukje verleden, heden, toekomst wat aangesproken wordt in principe. Dus het paranormale. Ja.
Sorry?
Ja, het is een stukje verleden, heden, toekomst wat wordt aangesproken. Dus zeg maar het paranormale.
Okay, so Wendy says this is a piece of the past, the present and the future, so that's why you can classify it as paranormal.
Ja, klopt. En het is een streven naar je onbewuste, gewoon de wens om jezelf te zijn, alles wat duidelijk wordt gezegd met deze kaart.
This is trying to see where you are at now and to try to get clarity to and answers to your own questions and thoughts.
Ja, ja. Dus daar staat de kaart voor. Het is in de onbewuste, wat eigenlijk als ware zichtbaar in de loop van de tijd. En zo kunnen mensen
dat,
dan...
Dat het onbewuste naar het bewuste komt, bedoel je dat?
Ja. Ja,
this is that the subconscious will become conscious.
Ja, dat klopt. En ja, daar staat de kaart voor. Ja.
Okay. Well, we've had quite a few cards, so I'll just go back. The first card we had for this week was the cauldron.
Ja.
Then we had the chalice. Then we had the dragon. And then we had the crystal ball.
Ja.
Okay, that was great fun. Thank you very much, Wendy.
Thank you.
And I hope to see you next week again.
Okay, take care. Thank you. Bye-bye, everyone.
And bye. Stay safe. Stay safe. Bye, Sven. Bye, Ivan.
Bye.
Bye, darling. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.